France's foreign minister has accused Australia and the US of lying over a new security pact that prompted Paris to recall its ambassadors.
In an interview with France 2 television, Jean-Yves Le Drian also accused the countries of duplicity, a major breach of trust and contempt.
The pact, known as AUKUS, will see Australia being given the technology to build nuclear-powered submarines.
The move thwarted a multi-billion dollar deal France had signed with Australia.
The agreement, which also includes the UK, is widely seen as an effort to counter China's influence in the contested South China Sea.
France was informed only hours before the public announcement was made earlier this week.
Speaking on Saturday, Mr. Le Drian said a serious crisis was in progress between the Allies.
The fact that for the first time in the history of relations between the United States and France we are recalling our ambassador for consultations is a serious political act, which shows the magnitude of the crisis that exists now between our countries, he told France 2.
He said the ambassadors were being recalled to re-evaluate the situation.
But he said France had seen no need to recall its ambassador to the UK, as he accused the country of constant opportunism.
Britain in this whole thing is a bit like the third wheel, he said.
Newly appointed UK Foreign Secretary Liz Truss defended the agreement in an article for the Sunday Telegraph, saying it showed Britain's readiness to be hard-headed in defense of its interests.
The pact means Australia will become just the seventh nation in the world to operate nuclear-powered submarines. It will also see the Allies share cyber capabilities, artificial intelligence and other undersea technologies.
The announcement ended a deal worth $37 billion that France had signed with Australia in 2016 to build 12 conventional submarines.
As he left Canberra on Saturday, French Ambassador Jean-Pierre Thibault called Australia's decision to unilaterally scrap the deal a huge mistake.
China meanwhile has accused the three powers involved in the security pact of having a Cold War mentality.
A White House official has said the Biden administration will engage with France in the coming days to resolve their differences.
Australian Foreign Minister Maurice Payne said she understood the disappointment in France and hoped to work with the country to ensure it understood the value we place on the bilateral relationship.